Plenty of sunshine here in downtown Wausau at our Bull Falls studios at the corner of Washington Street and North 3rd Street. The time is 8:07, 69 degrees is the temperature. It is Thursday, and good morning, and welcome to the Thursday edition of the Chad Holmes Show here on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Online at bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO and on the Civic Media app. Coming up this morning at 8:34, it's our weekly North Star Knows segment with North Star Restoration Services and North Star Builds. In the second hour of the show at 9:34, I will be talking to D.C. Police Officer Daniel Hodges. He was on duty during the January 6, 2021 insurrection at the U.S. Capitol, and I think a good day to talk to an officer from that day, as for the first time since 2021, Donald Trump is returning to the U.S. Capitol today. So we'll talk to Officer Daniel Hodges coming up at 9:34 this morning on the program. Also in the second hour, we will have another opportunity for you to win with the Civic Media Scani Summer Text-to-Win Contest. So stick around. We'll have your keyword coming up just after 9 o'clock. And, of course, we'll also be talking to Brittney Merlot about the weather coming up at 8:20 this morning as well. But to start things off, as we do on Thursday mornings, very happy to welcome back to the program the host of Up North News Radio. That's heard right before this program here on Bull Falls Radio, Pat Kreitlow. And, Pat, good morning.
No, Luke, we have to stop talking about Top Chef now. Luke, stop. I'm serious, Chad. We were talking about Top Chef, the second to final episode of Top Chef Wisconsin, and Luke Mathers is a big fan, and we said goodbye, and he kept going on, and he told me more about Top Chef until about 2 minutes ago than I'd ever thought I'd know. That man is a big, big fan. Big fan.
Two quick points before we delve into the serious stuff. At the start of every show, we hear a voice. And in the 7 o'clock hour, you mentioned the name of the person that does the voiceover for your show.
Intros?
Yeah. Does this person have a connection with you in your career?
Yes, he does. His name is Don Roux, R-O-U-X. Don is a radio veteran from across Northwest Wisconsin. Folks might have known him from, he actually worked at the station in Amory, which now belongs to Civic Media. He and I worked together at what was then WAQE up in Rice Lake, where he was the morning jock and I was the morning news guy. And so we would play on the radio in the mornings. I was 22 at the time. I forget how old he was. I don't remember if he's a little older, a little younger. And so we'd play on the radio till, you know, close to noon. And then from noon onward, we'd play in the bars of Rice Lake. And somehow Don and I are still alive. Hmm. And we are seasoned gentlemen and professional broadcasters now compared to what we were back then.
And the other point, and I really hate to correct you. But during during the last hour, you mentioned that it was Enos on the Dukes of Hazzard that was the guy that would go, you know, get those Duke boys. It was not Enos. Enos was actually buddies with the Duke boys. It was Roscoe P. Coltrane.
Roscoe! Oh, how could I miss that?
Well, when I was a kid, Friday nights were the Incredible Hulk and the Dukes of Hazzard.
So it's like, of course.
And I'm saying, it's not Enos. Enos was her buddy. It was Roscoe. Roscoe P. Coltrane.
We got a text line. You can send me a note next time. And you
that's
know,
a good point.
And say,
there you go.
Hey,
there you go.
I'm going to send you this text instead of humiliating you on live radio. But no, it's,
no. You're right. All right.
I take full responsibility for that.
No, so.
Because I was listening to what I was talking. I was thinking of James Comer from Kentucky.
Yeah.
You know, the head of the House Oversight Committee, and it was just in that same vein of, we're going to get those Duke boys and we're going to get that Biden crime family. It's like, oh God, this is what our Congress has become.
And I wanted to kind of touch on what you were talking about there with our as I sit here in the 7th Congressional District, our 7th District Congressman Tom Tiffany. And during the you played, I thought, a very relevant cut, which, you know, Tiffany always talks about. And it was Tom. I said, hey, that's our Tom. You know, I listened to that. That's our Tom. But the sad thing is, you know, in a sense, you kind of say, yeah, I mean, it's obvious that he's just, you know, again, reading those talking points. The unfortunate aspect is it's such a hard climb up the hill to get people to realize what he is saying is just a bunch of garbage. And when I was listening to that, that's what kind of hit me at the time. It's like I feel for the candidates that are running right now for the Democratic nomination here in the 7th. I feel for a lot of people that constantly are fighting because he does have the megaphone in order to get in front of, you know, cameras and microphones and the like. It is just very difficult in this era, and it's not just Tiffany, but this era, we're constantly fighting that kind of misinformation, aren't we?
Right. It was, I know Edward R. Murrow used to say it. I don't know that he was the first to say it, but he would say that, you know, in this technological age of, you know, television and radio broadcasting, you know, a lie can get halfway around the world while the truth is still putting on its tennis shoes. And that's what happens when you've created an entire right-wing, you know, media ecosystem, is you've created this echo chamber where if people who are either already predisposed to believe you politically, or, and this is the important distinction, or they were entertained by your show and just gradually came to believe all the things that you were saying. And I say that with great importance, because it explains the rise of people like Rush Limbaugh. And I'm happy to say that we never talk about Rush Limbaugh anymore.
No.
He's dead and gone, and nobody talks about him because he did nothing worthwhile with his life. But he created something that in the beginning was entertaining. I'd be the first to tell you that. Mm-hmm. Even as he was telling lie after lie after lie, people would listen and go, oh, I'm sure he's just spinning yarns, but look what we hath wrought from that. And they understand that if you just keep saying the same, you know, stuff over and over again, maybe you can get just enough people to believe it. Let me give you one great example of not something that was not necessarily an outright lie. I'm working on a story right now about paid family leave. Mm-hmm. And obviously where Trump and Biden are could not be more polar opposite. Biden wanted 12 weeks of paid family leave. Joe Manchin made him take it out of what became the Inflation Reduction Act. But here's my point. Donald Trump in 2016, when people thought, oh, he's fresh, he's new, he's different, he said in September of 2016 that he could go along with 6 weeks of paid family leave. That was an earthquake back then, people probably have forgotten. No Republican major candidate had come out in favor of any paid family leave. Well, it turned out he was basically just making it up because he was so far behind Hillary Clinton in the polls, he was trying anything to try to win back some voters. And they believed him. They said, oh, here's a Republican, finally. And now we know what Trump is. We know instead he did not favor any paid leave for most American workers. Instead, it was, well, you know what'll help you? Tax cuts, especially if those tax cuts are for those wealthy families. That's what it turned out to be. So people believe these things, and then they don't look at the record of whether what they said actually turned out to be true or not.
And that is such a good point when you talk about the record, because we keep talking about that here. It's about these people who are on the ballot, so many of them, well, the president, the Senate race, going right down the line, there are records. And also, when you talk about what is said and then what is done, we see more and more and more of disconnects. And I think, you know, you were talking in your last hour again with an assembly candidate and talking about how Dr. Lyerly put out her video talking about women's health care choice. There are so many still on the right-hand side of the aisle that will get in front of a microphone and say, no, we're not going to touch in vitro fertilization. We're not going to pass. Right. And then at the same time, you'll look at, you know, in the old days, it would be a newspaper or just flipping on your computer. They're still pushing legislation. There is still such a disconnect. And there's no shame, it feels like, for people to get in front of a microphone. Oh, no, this is not what we're going to do. And it goes back, I think, you know, back to when Scott Walker ran for governor. Oh, I will never, ever, ever pass, you know, these laws that involved and ultimately led to Act 10 or other basically union busting policies. Never said a word. Then during the run up to the election, then immediately that's what happens. I mean, it used to be where you would expect people to actually think, hey, if I said this during a campaign or during an interview, it kind of matters. Unfortunately, it doesn't seem to matter as much.
No, because again, that you don't get the same kind of penalty. And I don't just mean from voters. I mean from traditional journalists who should be spending their time calling out these kinds of things that, you know, the candidate said this, but it turns out they didn't get it done. But it turns out, as they learned from consultant after consultant after consultant, you know, there's no ratings in that. The ratings are in, you know, just carrying Donald Trump's next rally. And whatever he says, I mean, you can kind of fact check it later, kind of sort of, but there's so many lies, you can't possibly get to them all. And they're looking for the eyeballs. You know, they're looking for the listeners. They're looking for the readers rather than essentially shaming. Now, Tom Tiffany on CNN got a rare moment of shaming, where this anchor stopped him three different times and said, no, sir, that's not correct, and pointed out where he was again saying things that had been thoroughly debunked many times over. Now, that's not going to dissuade Tom Tiffany. In the old days, if you got busted on air one time for lying, that was kind of it for you. For him, he shrugs it off, says, oh, that's fake news, you know, and then he'll go on, you know, a very friendly local radio station or something, and he'll say the same old things, because we don't punish lying the way that we used to, the way that we should, and the way that I still feel we can get back to.
As a fact, I as I turn my head looking down the street, I think there's a big banner at a building that says, welcome Tom Tiffany, just down the road here here in Wausau.
got a banner welcoming him?
That's a radio station that loves to talk to Tom Tiffany just down the road.
Well, you know, you got to get your content someplace, and you know, sometimes so. Sometimes it's people you fact check, sometimes, you know, not so much. They fill air for you.
Pat Kreitlow, he is the host of Up North News Radio, again, every weekday morning from 6 until 8 a.m. right here on Bow Falls Radio. Pat, again, thanks for the time. Have a great rest of your day, and have a great weekend.
All right. Thanks. You too.
Coming up, it's 8:18. Coming up, we got a nice start here weather-wise in central Wisconsin. Again, we had some rain last night as I was laying in bed. I could hear the rain coming down pretty hard. But then this morning, boy, I looked outside and there was plenty of sunshine. And what can we expect here for Thursday and as we get to Father's Day weekend? Well, we'll find out as we're joined by meteorologist Brittney Merlot coming up. Chad Holmes Show, Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Welcome back. Chad Holmes Show, Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Online at bowfallsradio.com. Mobile devices by searching WXCO and on the Civic Media app. And again, you can also join us by going to the Bow Falls Radio page at facebook.com and x.com to see a video stream of our program and also be able to add your comments and join in as well. And again, you can also join us by either calling or texting us. The best way is to do it through the Civic Media app. Again, it's a free app. It's a terrific piece of technology. Be able to call or text with a punch of a button, or if you want to do it the old-fashioned way, you can use the old phone number, 715-382-9297. That's 715-382-9297. But the best reason, at least this week, to get the Civic Media app is because in the second hour of the show, again, we will give you an opportunity with the Civic Media Scani Summer Text to Win contest, and you need the app to do that. So again, we'll give you the keyword coming up after 9 o'clock, give you a chance to win an hourly, daily, or grand prize again. So if you have a chance here during the next 30 to 40 minutes before we get to 9, 9 o'clock, and you don't have the Civic Media app, just go to your Apple App Store, go to your Google Play, and search out Civic Media. Download the app. It's a free app. Then open it up, and you'll see all the Civic Media radio stations, the fifth one down, Bow Falls Radio, and you'll be ready to win. So we'll be giving you a little chance to take care of that before 9 o'clock. But right now, we need to find out about the weather. We're heading towards a holiday weekend, the Father's Day holiday weekend. And what can we expect weather-wise for the end of the work week and then heading towards the weekend? Well, the person that always has the answer is our meteorologist, Brittney Merlot. And Brittney, good morning.
Good morning, Chad. I'm so happy that Mother Nature did not wake up cranky, at least here in central Wisconsin.
That's interesting because last night I was laying in bed and I could hear the rain coming down, and it was coming down pretty hard at times. I didn't get up and take a look, but I could just hear it. It was coming down hard. And then again this morning, as we've had so many times in the last couple of weeks, you just look out and so much blue sky, temperature already around 70 degrees. I mean, just a fantastic start. But again, it's that time of year. You're going to see rain and then you'll get some nice weather. Never know when, but it's nice when it's overnight rain, and then when you wake up having so much sunshine like we do right now.
I agree. You can't complain about that. I'll take all of the rain while we're sleeping. That's the best. But yesterday, actually, Mosinee had some pea-sized hail, I saw in reports. So a decent-sized storm rolled through there, but we missed a good chunk of the severe weather. I mean, there was trees in Amory falling on cars. Winds were gusting up to 50 to nearly 60 miles per hour down south as well. So a lot of tree damage and wind damage, but that is now in the past. Now today, we have to deal with the rising humidity. It's going to get sticky out there this afternoon. The heat, we're going to climb to temperatures in the low 80s today. And it's just, I can already feel it in my house. It's already creeping in. It's one of those days you want to maybe turn the AC on. Have you fallen for that yet, Chad, by the way?
I gotta know. I have. I've been weak at times. I have turned on the air conditioner probably when I shouldn't have, but and you call me out on it no less.
No, you're smart, because here I am sleep deprived because I am having a hard time sleeping with that added humidity and not turning the AC on just yet. So I'm gonna cave. I think I'm gonna cave on Sunday. Sunday's the day. But I don't have the central AC. It's so easier. So much easier to flip.
Actually, you know? In my room, I can't get the coolness to there either. So it's only in the living area that I can actually use the AC. So, but I shouldn't have. I feel all guilty about that. Oh, doggone it.
No, don't. We're all going to do, we're all joining you on Sunday because we're going to be in the upper 80s.
Really?
Southern Wisconsin, yeah, they're going to hit 90 degrees. It is just going to be summer weather right here Sunday for Father's Day. Now, it's just going to be very active too. We have this big heat dome building in, and we're going to stay warm next week as well. But the chances of showers and storms are pretty much every single day starting on Sunday. So
between now and then, can we get those outdoor activities going? Because again, as I look outside right now, I'm thinking, man, I wish I could just grab the golf clubs, get out there right now. Is it going to stay this way for the rest of today, maybe at least until early in the weekend?
I think that if you want to go golfing or try to cut the grass or something like that outside, I think you're going to get away with it today. There is the smallest chance of a few spotty showers throughout the afternoon, mainly around lunch, like 12 to 2. After that, abundant sunshine and the humidity leaves. So we're just sitting here waiting for a cold front to pass. It doesn't look like it sparks a lot up here for us. That looks stronger down in the southern parts of the state, but maybe a little cloudier through the lunch hour, a few little sprinkles, then we're done. We're dry for the rest of the day. We're dry and comfortable tomorrow. The humidity's gone. We're going to be sitting in the mid-70s, and it'll be fantastic until about Saturday night, Sunday morning. So, then we're going to get hit with some heavy rain and storms.
So basically, we're going to get a break from the thickness, at least for a couple of days. And then as it happens this time of year, some other piece of weather is going to move into the area by the time we do get to Sunday, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Unfortunately. But hey, you know what, though? I do think I've heard a lot of feedback. I think a lot of dads like to sit outside in the garage and watch thunderstorms. So maybe it's my gift to you guys.
Maybe it is. A little excitement, I guess. But man, oh man. What are the details here as we get to the end of the work week and into the weekend?
Absolutely. So sunny for a good chunk of today. We're only going to get cloudy with a few spotty showers this afternoon. It's going to get humid, Highs hitting 80 degrees, but as the winds switch behind the cold front this evening, it's going to get comfortable. And for tomorrow, we'll have highs in the mid-70s with abundant sunshine. And we're going to put that on repeat for our Saturday as well. Up until the evening, that's when the humidity builds back in. The heat starts to rise. Showers and thunderstorms Saturday night and into Sunday. It does look like a drencher where we could see about a half an inch to an inch of rainfall. Then we might clear out a little bit on Sunday afternoon before more storms are possible on Sunday evening. And a very active and hot week. Like I said, Sunday near 90 for portions of the state. I think here we'll hit the mid-80s. And that heat continues into next week. So, woo.
Well, I tell you, again, we're going to soak up the beautiful sunny mornings. Again, we've had so many of those. It's this time of year, it's nice to get up early, come to work, and see all the sunshine and not have to put a jacket on, as I said yesterday. It's just, you know, it's really, really a great time of year for those of us who do work early in the morning. So I appreciate that. I appreciate all the information. Brittany, have a great rest of your Thursday. Enjoy the sunshine, and we'll talk again tomorrow.
Bye, thanks, Brittany. You as well. Have a good one.
Right now in downtown Wausau at our studios at the corner of Washington Street and North 3rd Street, temperature of 69 degrees. The winds are out of the southwest at 12 miles per hour, gusting as high as 20 miles per hour. The dew point is 63, relative humidity of 81%. The barometer at 29.73 inches and a visibility of 10 miles. So again, as you head off to wherever you are, heading to work, heading off to anything else you're doing, a really nice way to start off this morning. Coming up, it's an information update. We will have news, weather, and sports. We'll have the national news, international news. We'll have Terry Bell with our civic media state update. Brittany will be back with an update on the area news and weather. Mike Clemens will have the sports. So again, at the top and bottom of every hour, we give you all the information you need here on Bull Falls Radio. And then after that, it is Thursday. You know what that Thursday morning means? It means the last half hour of the first hour is North Star Knows with North Star Restoration and North Star Builds. So that will be coming up. Chad Holmes, along with Ian Welsh, Chad Holmes Show, Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. And welcome back, Chad Holmes Show on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Online at bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app. And again, you can also join us on our live video stream by going to our Facebook.com and X.com pages. Search out Bull Falls Radio. But it is Thursday morning. That means it's another chance to bring in the guys from North Star Restoration, North Star Builds, Jay Cricks and John Garcia. North Star Knows here on both Bull Falls Radio. Gentlemen, good morning.
Good morning, Chad. Good morning. How's it going?
I tell you, you guys are a busy bunch of bees over at North Star. Every time we come in here, you're usually talking about multiple events that are going on. Of course, last week you had the Parade of Homes, and you have the Rod and Bike Show coming up. But let's start off with the Parade of Homes, because we've been talking a lot about that in recent weeks. The actual event occurred. How did it go?
It was great. I mean, they had record attendance. It was 3,200 people that came through. I think the highest number since then was 2019, and that was like 2,900.
Oh, wow.
Smashed the record.
And so there's a lot of people.
And did North Star have more people come through than anybody else?
It was very close. We'll find out tonight at the dinner, but yeah, it was pretty close for numbers. It was way more busy than I thought it would be. That's for sure.
Oh, kept you on your toes, right? Yeah.
I mean, even, you know, starting on a Tuesday, you would think not that many people would come, and all
of a sudden
it was
just,
yeah, it was busy the whole time. And, you know, they start at noon and 11 on the weekend, and, you know, you would think like, oh, the first hour will probably be, you know, a few people trickle in. No, there was people there 5 minutes beforehand ready to go in, and it was just nonstop. So
right to
it was
the
awesome.
End.
Very cool.
The show was wrapping up at like 9, was it 9 p.m. on, was that Thursday night?
Yep, Thursday and Friday.
And there was people coming right at 5 to 9.
Yeah, 5 to 9.
Can we just peek inside? Absolutely.
I got to ask you guys, you know, and John especially, because I know that you spend a lot of time out there. When you do see that, is there a little annoyance? You're thinking, I've been talking all day long. I've been explaining this home. I've been answering questions. I'm almost ready, probably ready to grab a bite to eat.
Yeah.
And then somebody who's excited to see your home. Right. Obviously, that's the thing. But you just say, okay, suck it up.
Right, yeah. Yeah, you pretty much just, hey, come on in. We'll take you through.
Very good.
Answer any questions.
And again, this coming weekend, it is the 7th annual Rod and Bike Show. We talked about it with Pookie before as
bit,
well.
Yeah.
She was very, very terrific as she came in and talked about it. But let's get into it again because it is coming up this weekend, correct?
It is. So, you know, the history behind this event, it started off as just like a little gathering for a local car club, the Wisconsin Road Knights. And we're one of the supporting businesses of that car club. And once a year, everybody would gather at our shop. And it started off at, you know, 25, 30 cars. And then the next year it was, you know, 45, 50 cars. Then 50, 60 cars. And then next thing you know, it's like, it's too big for our parking lot at NorthStar. So we happened to move during that time into our new facility, and it just got so big that we decided to find a strategic partner. And it went from the annual NorthStar Charity Car Show to the Central Wisconsin Rod and Bike Show, and we partnered with Harley-Davidson. This will be our third year working with Harley, and we get several hundred cars now. And, you know, all the motorcycles come in, and plus you're at Harley-Davidson, mm-hmm. so they've got hundreds of motorcycles there and a huge parking lot. And just so happens that Camping World is right on the backside of Harley. So there's like a big fence that divides the two businesses. So the businesses get together, we open up the fence, mm-hmm. and they pull out some campers, and we give away some really cool raffle prizes. And it's almost like not quite a block party, but it's like a block party to where it's like people are coming and going, coming in from the Camping World side, pulling into Harley-Davidson. You know, we've got all the cars, all the bikes there, and the event just continues to grow and grow each and every year. You know, they used to have the old car show on the 400 block on Father's Day weekend, and that sort of went away. And our car show was always a little bit later in the year. So we decided when that weekend opened up, like, you know what? The Wausau area, the Central Wisconsin area, needs a big car show, you know, because we don't have the 400 block one anymore. Mm-hmm. So, like, let's move our date. Let's take that. Let's plant our flag on that Saturday of Father's Day weekend. And it just continues to gain momentum each and every year.
Isn't that a cool feeling when you start an event or sort of get involved with another group, whatever it may be, when you start something new? And it just does that, where you see the progress, and then all of a sudden you turn around and something that was, you know, as you said, just a
tiny.
Few folks, people coming by, really having a good time.
Yeah.
But then one year turn around and say, holy cow, it's gotten so big we don't have the room. That's got to make you feel really good.
Yeah, it's really cool, especially when you share the vision with another, you know, entity, and they're like, yeah, we see the value in this. Let's do this together. And, yeah, when, you know, you got a couple decent, you know, business partners working together, you can really make something happen. So that's basically what's happened with this event. So all the money, it started off as a clothing drive. You know, we'd grill out, you know, serve some food, and then we would collect winter weather clothing for our homeless and in need veterans and veteran families right here in Central Wisconsin. And the clothes get distributed through the Red Cross Service to Armed Forces Outreach Program, or SAF. So they've got a list of in need veterans and, you know, veteran families. And they deploy all the clothes out. And the stuff stays right here in Central Wisconsin. So it's everything from, you know, new socks, underwear, T-shirts, stuff like that, to gently used winter weather clothing. So bibs, jackets, hats, mittens, gloves. And it seems like, why are we collecting this stuff in, you know, June? But it takes a while to disperse the items. You know, you see these clothing drives in like September and October, like it's already getting cold by October. So we like to get the stuff collected. Anything that's gently used will run through, you know, our washing machines at NorthStar, make sure everything's nice and clean, and then we turn it over to the Red Cross. So that's one of the charities that, you know, we drive the, you know, some of this goodwill towards. The other one is the Wausau Firefighters Community Assistance Foundation. So the firefighters are gracious enough. In the past, they've shown up just to donate, and now they're kicking in. They are going to be running the bar So there are bartenders. They'll be serving root beer floats. And then any money that we make off the bar goes right back to the Wausau Firefighters Community Assistance Foundation. And they use the funds. They've got a couple different missions that their funds go towards. Obviously, if they find an in-need family right here in the area, because our first responders are the first ones getting into a lot of these homes.
Mm-hmm.
So if they find somebody in need, they can go back to the fire department, get them a gift card, and then help fulfill that need. They also have a dream vacation program, so any first responder that's killed or sustains a career-ending injury, they use their funds to send that family on a dream vacation when they're ready to take that step forward. And then the third mission that they have is they have a scholarship program. So if you've been identified as somebody that wants to, you know, be a first responder or a firefighter, what happens is if you go through the they help pay for your schooling up at the tech, and then you have to commit to, I believe it's three years at a local fire department, and it's paid for through their scholarship foundation. So it's really cool. They're giving back into our community.
Yeah.
You know, we want to give back. Harley wants to give back. So it's like, hey, let's do this together and make sure. And it doesn't raise a ton of money, but it's always a good time. It, you know, every penny counts. So we're trying to drive the money towards, you know, good stuff. And then this year we thought, you know what, let's do a third one. So we invited the Kiwanis to come in. And
the more the merrier.
Yeah,
right?
The more the merrier. Because we've always done like the coffee and the donuts in the morning for the early birds. Because you got those guys there. You know, the car show registration starts at 8. And there they are at 6:30 in the parking lot. You know, so we've always done free coffee and donuts for the early birds. We don't mind it. A lot of the guys that show up early are our car club members, and they're also going to be helping with parking and setting up registration, stuff like that. But you know what? Instead of just coffee and donuts, let's do a pancake feed. So that's going to be pretty cool. It's our first time. The Kiwanis are going to organize it, but pancakes from 8 to 10. And I'm excited to get some, you know, some pancakes and some syrup, you know.
I tell you, and again, it's something that over the months now that we've been doing this, and when we talk about the different events and the different activities that NorthStar is involved with your partners, that is such a, again, I mean, every time we talk about it, it comes across so very clearly that being part of the community, helping the community in some way is part of the mission of what you're trying to accomplish.
It is. And I've said it before, but the mission of NorthStar, you know, is to improve the quality of life of our employees, our customers, and those in the community whose lives we touch. So any way that we can have that touch with our community and just continue to help out, that's where we're at. So just as, I guess, as a reminder, it's this Saturday, June 15th. Registration starts at 8 a.m. Voting ends at 2. We'll be handing out trophies at 3 o'clock. We've got live music all day long. It should be a great time. So if you're looking for something to do with your dad or your grandpa on Father's Day weekend, you know, we'd love for you to stop down and check us out down at Bull Falls Harley-Davidson down at Cronin-Rudder.
And to underline it, it is a family-friendly event. I mean, 100%. I think that's something
it's
that,
free to the public.
Again, everybody, I mean, you don't have to be one of the gearheads who, you know, it's really something that you can expose the kids to, the grandkids to, and just really have a wonderful time with everybody. Make it a true holiday weekend experience.
It is. It's a family-friendly event. It's free to the public. We'll be giving out free rip your floats for dad and the kids.
Perfect time of year too. It'll be in the 80s.
Yep, exactly. And weather's supposed to be beautiful.
Yeah, love those rip your floats. I tell you, those are fantastic. So again, that is the 7th annual Rod and Bike Show coming up. Again, just a wonderful event with NorthStar Restoration, NorthStar Builds, and all their partners as well. Again, it is NorthStar Knows here on Bow Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230. BowFallsRadio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO. Chad Holmes along with Jay Cricks and John Garcia. And I know that coming up here, we're going to talk about another topic, aging in place repairs. But we got just a couple of minutes before we take our 1 minute deep breath here on NorthStar Knows. But again, the partnerships. And I want to ask you, John, again, you talk to so many people at events such as the Parade of Homes. What did you find out this time around? Did you find out any, in terms of the questions on, what are on people's minds when it comes to new homes and what you do at NorthStar Builds?
A lot of people had questions about the products themselves and the longevity. So we noticed a lot of people asking about the heating system, you know, what was being used for heating. So we have in-floor heat in that house, which is ran by a boiler. Then there's also a high-velocity HVAC system, which is pumping in AC and then also heat in areas when needed. A lot of people focused on windows, the type of windows, you know, what the material makeup was, if they were double pane or triple pane, It seemed like everybody had a lot of questions about, hey, if I'm going to be building, what type of product should I be putting in my house? Because they definitely want to spend a little more and get a little better product mm-hmm. that's going to last a lot longer because they plan on being there for many years and never leaving. Mm-hmm. So they want right. everything to be pre-planned as much as possible. Another thing I talk to people about a lot is, hey, if you're looking to build, let's say in 2026, you're looking to build, start the planning process right now. Mm-hmm. I said, and I even told people, I said, we can, if you're looking to build with us, we can get you set up on JobTread, which is our program that we use. And we can actually have a thread of photos and ideas yeah, and different floor plans.
Interesting.
And have a year's worth of planning ahead of time.
Right.
That way, when it comes to it, everyone's on the same page. We all have the same understanding of what the homeowner wants, what they expect from us, and it just it helps out the process. You can't have enough time to plan your home build or a remodel.
Are people getting more knowledgeable as the years go by? When you talk to folks and you start these discussions, do you find that they are more prepared for what they're trying to accomplish than maybe they were a number of years ago?
Yeah, I would say the internet and just all the even like videos now that you have on Facebook, Instagram, you know, even TikTok, you know, there's so many videos out there. There's a lot of good information. There's a lot of false information too. But for the most part, I think because of how the internet has developed and we have all these better websites out there and people that are posting, mm-hmm. you know, information that they're getting more informed, which is a good thing. So that way they know coming in kind of what to expect, what they can get and what options are out there versus just kind of being in the dark.
You mentioned, and we're going to come back in just over a minute and start to talk about aging in place, because as you said, people like to be able to be in their homes for a very long time.
Exactly.
And this is a very interesting topic. So we're going to come back with John Garcia, Jay Cricks, NorthStar Restoration Services, NorthStar Builds. Every Thursday, it is NorthStar Knows here on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, online at bowfallsradio.com, mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app. And again, you can also watch us and see us by going to facebook.com and x.com, search out the Bow Falls Radio page, and then you can also add your comments and join us as well. So we'll be back in just over a minute. NorthStar Knows on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Welcome back. NorthStar Knows on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, bowfallsradio.com, mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO on the Civic Media app. And again, don't forget, if you've missed any of the discussions, talking about a lot of different issues that NorthStar Restoration and NorthStar Builds deals with, you can always go back to our podcast page. Go to bowfallsradio.com, click on shows, go to civicmedia.us, click on shows, or just go to wherever you get your podcasts, because we have all of our shows posted. And again, you can catch up on anything you may have missed here on NorthStar Knows. Again, with Jay Cricks and John Garcia, I'm Chad Holmes. Aging in place. And again, it is important. It's an important topic, isn't it? What makes it important?
So 77% of adults 50 and older want to stay in their home
yeah.
for long term. They want a safe home. They want things to be easily accessible. They want to be able to grow with the home and not have issues, you know, 20 or 30 years later where they can't access certain areas of their home or right. they can't do certain things that they used to be able to do. So really, aging in place is all about how can we incorporate universal design to basically plan ahead and alter things in the home to make them as age-friendly as possible as everybody gets older. So when we're talking about that, you know, even let's say you have a bathroom remodel coming up
mm-hmm.
and it's your master bathroom, you know, when you're looking at it, okay, maybe you want to have a tile shower. Well, most tile showers, we install a curb that you're going to have to step over to get into the tile shower. Well, if you're going to be there a long time, you may want to look at putting in a curbless shower. So that way you're going from the main floor right into the shower. There's no right. curb. There's nothing in the way. You can walk in easy. You could pull a wheelchair in, anything you want. So those are the types of things that when we're talking about aging in place is looking at how to improve the overall design and function of the home. So that way it's going to help everybody out in the long run when they age.
Again, this is my question from this side of the table that says, hey, maybe I don't know what I'm talking about part of the show. But when I listen to you talk about, you know, trying to be basically prepared for not just years, but maybe even decades for these folks, are you able to build in a way that makes adjustments easier? Maybe you don't have to have everything in terms of what you may need down the line, but in a way that when you need to make maybe an adjustment, that is, it's a lot simpler than maybe a major refurnishment or something.
Correct.
Like that.
Yeah, I mean, like, let's say a master bathroom, let's say you need to save money now and you're going to put in a fiberglass unit currently, but that is something that isn't a super high cost, and yet you could take that out later on down the road and put in a curbless shower afterwards. And when you're gonna, let's say you save money for a decade or whatever it is, you know, putting blocking in place in certain areas ahead of time when you're doing a remodel, you know, if you know, you know, going into the shower, you know, maybe we don't want one now because it's gaudy and it's going to be in the way, we don't need it, but let's put the proper blocking on that in the wall for framing and have that on a plan somewhere. So we know, hey, this block is 42 inches from the corner. It's from, you know, 54 inches to 72 inches high, and it's a 2x8. Mm-hmm. That way we know ahead of time, it's like, okay, in 10, 15, 20 years, hey, we're going to install grab bars now in these certain areas. Now we can go ahead and do that. And we're not, you know, tearing up, open the wall, having to put in blocking. And then now you're paying for drywall patching, texture, paint, and all the additional costs. So just those little things that don't take a lot of time or have a lot of cost associated with them. But if we, like I said, if you take the time to pre-plan and handle those things in the front end, it's going to help out in the end.
And I was just, you actually took the words out of my mouth, because I was going to say, it goes back to what you did say a few minutes ago about when you're going through this process, if you're not rushing the process, it allows you to think probably a lot clearer and have that plan of, you know, not just in a year to maybe to think about what do you ultimately want. And again, that's the importance of that pre-planning, isn't it?
I mean, the worst part is when you can sense that a homeowner is rushed about something because they're trying to get something done last minute, right? And it's like, everything feels rushed. The decisions, they may not be able to pick things that they want because the lead time is too far out for their timeline. That's why you really need to look ahead and say, hey, we're going to do this kitchen remodel in this year. We're going to do this bathroom remodel, and give yourself the proper time, because, you know, I don't like when things are rushed. The homeowner doesn't like when things are rushed. So the more time we can allot, the better. And we can think of ideas like this and say, hey, you know, are you going to plan on being here forever? Maybe let's look at, you know, installing, you know, waist high appliances in your house, or let's get some smart lighting installed in certain areas. So, you know, when you're about to go to bed, you can click a button instead of going around the entire house and turning off all the lights that maybe you had your kids over earlier and their grandkids, and they turned on every light in the house because they're, you know, playing hide and seek or whatever it was. So you can go and just open up your phone or have a smart switch on the wall in the main hallway and be able to turn everything off and not have to worry about it.
And it also, again, we often talk about people's budgets, and obviously budgets are vitally important as well. And again, it does not have to be a budget buster, does it?
Correct. Yeah. I mean, a lot of these smart devices keep coming down in price. And it's just adjustments to the design beforehand. They're not going to add a ton of cost by any means. You know, certain things, obviously curbless shower, you know, is going to add, you know, 10%, 10 to 15% to your shower build, potentially on the size of it. But really in the grand scheme of things, it's not a lot of money when you're talking about, okay, we installed a tile shower with a curb. Now, 15 years later, we're going to tear it all out and redo it. And now you're looking at a big expense because you got to re-waterproof everything. You basically have to take the shower out and redo it.
And also, finally, it sounds like we're talking a lot about, you know, being set up for so we get older, become more elderly. It's not necessarily just about, you know, elderly as well.
Yeah. I mean, it's just as we get older, maybe we don't want 20 steps we have to walk up, or maybe we want to put a ramp in the garage, you know, just to make it easier going up and down, or maybe you're carrying in a lot of things. You have sports and, you have a lot of kids and you're always hauling stuff up and down the steps, just things that are going to make your life a little more safer in your home as well, not just because of, you know, aging. Mm-hmm. Also, another unique Jay and I were actually talking about is, if you're planning a new home build, put in the pantry attached to the garage so we could put in a little hatch door where you can put your groceries in right on the floor in your pantry and you're not having to walk them all in your house.
Very cool. Yep. I like that idea. Yeah, that's a great one to finish off on.
We were talking about that earlier.
John Garcia, Jay Cricks. Again, we got to remind folks again this weekend, make plans to join you guys.
We want you to know us before you need us. So come down and check us out at Bull Falls Harley Davidson, down at Cronenretter, Saturday. Registration starts at 3. We hand out trophies. Our registration starts at 8 a.m. We hand out trophies at 3 o'clock. It should be a great time. Lots of food, music, good times.
Terrific. Jay Cricks, John Garcia, thanks again. We'll have NorthStar Knows next week.
Yes, sir.
See you then.
An information update coming up next here on WXCO.